in this generation now, it will be possible for all men to become so competent that everyone would be making right decision for all good. How it will be brought about by science of creative intelligence is very, very obvious. We know in these days of technology, a small computer will compute small things. A bigger computer will compute much bigger things. Many more datas can be brought about by a bigger computer than what are introduced in it. A bigger computer has the ability of greater comprehension. An ordinary man, suppose without the knowledge of architecture, if he wants to think of how he will construct his house, he would consider things one by one. A well-educated mind of a qualified architect, when he sits on his table to construct the house on the level of his awareness, his quiet, calm mind comprehends many things at a time. He takes into account the site, the background of it, the need of the owner, the financial ability. All these various aspects are contained in the awareness of an experienced architect. A layman can only project his awareness on small, small channels of the house, here, here. And the danger in the ability of only projecting the awareness on limited channels is that the sight of the whole is lost. And if the object is well placed in the proper background, then the value that it offers to life is much more enriching, much more inspiring. And therefore, it is vital that even when one wants to make a decision in a narrow boundary, because decisions always have to be regarding this or this or this or this, they have boundaries. But the decision has to be from that unbounded level, where great comprehension is possible at one time. If one is in a boat in the ocean and is surrounded by all the waves here, there, there, he looks around but he can't see a great distance. Just because there are upheavals, there are waves to obstruct his vision. But if he launches his boat on a quiet day where the wind is almost nil, he finds calm, quiet surface of the ocean. In whatever direction he looks far. The vision is more comprehensive when the surface of the ocean is calm. This is just the situation with the mind. When the mind is wavy like that, its ability to comprehend greater horizon is much less. When the waves of the mind are calm, quiet, in that pure consciousness, motionless, ground state, what Dr. Domesh said yesterday, a field of no activity, yet awareness is quite intact. Such an awareness comprehends great horizon, great range, and then whatever decision is made from that very wide horizon of awareness. It comprehends greater range of influence. Just as a quiet, calm mind of an architect is able to take into his awareness so many aspects at a time. See, all this huge military operation in the wars is structured in the great deep silence of the commanding generals. Just because he is able to have his perception on the whole and being aware of the whole, he can take into account the well-being and all the features with reference to one operation which he wants to accomplish. So, this cultivation of a level of awareness which maintains tranquility in the midst of all the activities of the mind inside and of the environment outside, that state of tranquility spontaneously gives the ability of greater range of comprehension. And on this, the mind is like a very big computer which can instantly take into account very many aspects and produce the desired channel of performance. So, the ability to comprehend great, and on that extensive, wide comprehension, project the desired direction of activity is the ability of a developed mind. Developed is what we say, full potential. Full potential of the ocean for any practical application on its surface value is when the ocean is calm and quiet. Certainly, the value of that calm and quiet, far extended range of comprehension is in creating a wave which will comprehend all that wide range of possibility. It's a wave. The whole ocean could rise in a wave, and that will be only when the ocean has a chance to rise from that quiet surface level. This is the practical value of direct experience of that which we say pure nature of creative intelligence at the source of thought, or the transcendental value of awareness. So, just as in order to comprehend wider range of calculations or data, we are computing huge computers. The memory of computer is great because it can quickly locate many things and come to a conclusion, produce something. In this advanced age of technology, when the construction of big computers to shorten the range of calculation and to make it possible that many complicated things could be resolved in a very short time. And then this is the basis of all the moon flight and all the advancement in the field of civilization that is going on. Computer is adding a very great momentum to greater speed in progress. So when this outer progress is found to be based on bigger computers, certainly the basis of all progress, which is intelligence, also could be greater by structuring a bigger computer on the level of consciousness, awareness. And that is by silencing the activity, that's all. silence the activity, and then this is what Dr. Domesh proved from physics yesterday. Just keep on silencing the activity and you come to the absolute level of order, from where only order can rise. And from that level alone, absolute order can arise. And by absolute order here, we mean spontaneous right decision. And when we say right decision, we mean decision for good, for progress. So the science of creative intelligence structures in a very natural and automatic manner, effortless manner, that much needed computer in everyone's awareness, in which one would be able to comprehend unbounded horizon of life, and from there every impulse of such awareness, every impulse of thought, decision, every activity of mind and intellect will be only progressive, evolutionary, to find the final goal of fulfillment quickly. So this spontaneity of making decision, is just like the child feels mother is at home. In his awareness, it's just that very subtle impulse, mother at home, and that's all. His awareness is not considering what are the benefits of mother being at home, he'll get food in time and no one can beat him and all kinds of things. He doesn't have all those many things on his conscious mind. What he has is deep within the conscious mind, a faint impulse of feeling mother at home. All the multifarious advantages are not available separately on his conscious awareness, but that one faint impulse, mother at home, and all his decisions, greatest creativity he exposes in his thinking, actions, completely free, grows in freedom, but with that impulse. Just like that, the mind, established in that unbounded awareness, pure consciousness, feels mother at home. That stability, that profundity of self-confidence in a spontaneous, natural manner comes with that awareness which is unrestricted. And on that, maximum creative intelligence in a spontaneous manner. This spontaneity of right decision in the direction of evolution towards all good is emphasized. This spontaneity. Otherwise, it's not possible for us to make decisions on the basis of our ability to consider so many implied things in one channel. No. Mind has to make decisions constantly. Innumerable decisions have to be made throughout. Every thought has to be ascertained. But all these fixing up of the direction of activity on the basis of thought is never possible on the basis of counting how many possibilities are there and which should be rejected and which should be accepted and all that. Nothing can be done. The stream of life will not flow on this intellectual gymnasium. It has to be spontaneous. And in that spontaneity, always, whatever decisions are spontaneously made, they will be right and right and right and right and right. This is the glory of science of creative intelligence, that it whereas it is perfectly scientific and logical, it structures a computer in one's awareness in which every impulse will be progressive. Otherwise, it's not possible. Every action is effectively associated with everything in the environment, with the whole creation. Universe reacts to individual action. Whatever we do, we raise a hand, create impulses, and they go to strike against everything here and there and there and there. Someone breathing on the moon and here is being recorded. The whole space is being thrilled by every breath. The leaf moves and then it's thrilling the whole space in the universe. When such is the great range of influence of every single activity in creation, then what can be that intellect which will sit and decide, oh, I'm doing this, and what will be the influence of this here, there, in the moon, in the sun, on the rose, on the leaf, and can't be thought of in this way separately. Therefore, there has to be something whereby whatever impulse of thought rises, it is from its very nature life-supporting. And this will be only when the decisions are made, when the thoughts arise from that comprehensive, unbounded level of awareness, which is, when we say home of all knowledge, then in this context we want to add that that level of unbounded awareness is the home of all laws of nature as well. Just as all the laws of nature that are functioning to structure the stem or the leaf and the color of the rose and petal, all these laws are functioning on the level of colorless, unmanifest sap. On that level, some law is structuring the petal, making it green. On that level, some law is structuring the stem, making it brownish, reddish, like that. So all the laws of nature responsible to structure everything in creation are on that unmanifest level of life. When our awareness opens to that, our awareness virtually gains the status of the home of all the laws of nature. The home of all the laws of nature. And no law would rebel against its home, against its basis. And this is how, in a spontaneous manner, that level of awareness gains support of all the laws of nature. And the support of all the laws of nature means only one thing. The impulse will be in the progressive direction. The direction of activity will be evolutionary. So, by stabilizing that unbounded level of awareness, what we are doing is spontaneously structuring within ourselves the ability which will project thoughts only in the direction of evolution. Decisions will spontaneously be in the direction of evolution, in the direction of all good. Everything life-supporting for everything. Life-supporting not only for the thinker or the doer, but life-supporting for the whole creation. And this is that which we say cosmic intelligence. When the intelligence is unbounded, intelligence is cosmic, then it will compute the direction of action which can only do good, bring only life-supporting influence for the doer and for the whole creation. It was this which made the philosophy of action pronounce a formula for action. Established in being, perform action. Established in absolute intelligence, perform action. base your activity on that field of pure intelligence, which in itself is non-active. Such a beautiful knowledge of life. Mind is creative, it is spontaneously, by its own nature, active. But in order to make the activity worthwhile, in order that that activity meets with its goal, fulfillment, achievement, it is necessary that the mind, which initially initiates an activity, should be established on that level of awareness which is naturally supported by all the laws of nature and which serves to be the home of all knowledge. And based on that level of awareness, every inspiration of the mind, thought, desire, intention, activity will be only life-supporting for the doer and for everything. Help thy neighbor can only arise from that level of awareness. This is the basis of all which we may term right life or good life, life helpful for everything in creation in a spontaneous manner. This is the gift of the science of creative intelligence. Now the creative intelligence is already functioning. Mind is active. The whole thing is going on. The systematic study of this basic intelligence, which is underlying all phenomenon and all activity of the individual, of the society, of the world, of the whole universe. The systematic study of this brings to our intellectual understanding that it is possible for us to structure that most efficient computing system in our awareness, whereby every impulse can only be life-supporting and good. Such a beautiful knowledge of life, and at the cost of no doing. The whole principle that is involved in this experience of that unbounded awareness and in stabilizing that unbounded awareness for all times is the principle of no doing, the principle of least action. That's why in our movement one thing has become popular, we say, do less and accomplish more. Minimize the activity, and on that basis of minimizing activity, the activity will be most effective, most profound, most fulfilling, for not only for the actor, for the doer, but for the whole creation. This is the technique of living. And the only thing, the knowledge is full, the only thing is to ring the bell of every home, and this world plan will do it. Someone said the other day, the world plan seems to be very, say, sort of frightening. I said, no. When one knows what the world plan is, then one knows it's the most innocent plan of the world. Because it's just an educational inspiration to train the teachers of this wonderful knowledge which will enliven the life of every man, make a man live fullness of life. And the world plan is to train such teachers, that's all. It's such a holy inspiration to have this knowledge available to everyone in such a simple way. And because the very nature of life is to evolve, because nature itself is meant only to promote evolution, science of creative intelligence is only meant to promote evolution in an effortless way, forwarding the knowledge of least performance and maximum achievement. And therefore, that cosmic creative intelligence responsible for creation and maintenance of the universe will take care of the spreading of this beautiful knowledge so that every home receives it, every heart receives it. It's in keeping with the progressive wave of the time. This time in the history of human race is a time for progress, evolvement. And when this knowledge comes, which furthers the purpose of evolvement and shows the promise for quick evolvement of all the living beings, we have the support of Almighty Nature. But we have only to do things. This is the age of automatic machinery. There was a time when every operation was done by every man in this and this and this. And now one is asked only to press the button and be there to see that everything goes on. Automatic machinery age. Age of automatic machine is now calling for structuring in every mind that automatic system of computing whereby every life will be lived in fullness, abundance, success, fulfillment by just a press button operation. Water the root, do one operation, enjoy the fruit through so many operations that go along in a natural way. Leaves, branches, everything becomes fresh and fresh and bolder and rich, and then we get the beautiful fruit. But the operation is only one. Do less and accomplish more. Principle of least action, which is cherished by nature. The whole thing is so natural and the whole possibility is so enormous. That is why we want all the educated people to become teachers of this science of creative intelligence and let the knowledge be shared by all.